Good morning, church. Good to see everybody today. My name is Tony Shoemaker. I have the privilege of being the pastor here at the Middleville United Methodist Church. We welcome you today here in person and to those online. We have made a change this week, and you guys have already figured that change out. We have opened up the church so that we can use every chair and every pew. As we get closer to that 100 mark, we need to be able to use all of the seating, but we still need to keep socially distanced, about 6 feet from another household. We are keeping the mask on at this time. We are looking for the day when we'll be able to take them down while we're seated, but we're just watching the numbers. Out of curiosity, how many of you have had at least one shot? Wow. Very good. How many of you are fully vaccinated like I am? Okay. It's moving along. It's moving along well. Very good. God is good. All the time. Amen. Amen. We continue in our series, Picturing Ourselves in the Story, and we are now up to picture number 4, and this is, could be thought to be an alabaster jar today. I know it was put up here intentionally. We have a very challenging theme today. It was very challenging for me, and I'll talk about that in a little bit. It's called Risking Rejection. So to prepare for our service today, let us begin with a prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this opportunity to gather together today in person and online. We thank you for the beautiful sunshine. We thank you for this series that challenges us to be there in those Bible times. When Jesus was in the last week of his earthly life, and to hear him share with us what it is we need to see. We get so preoccupied sometimes with our own opinions that we often do not see Jesus at work or those who are offering blessings. So Lord, in this day, may you open our spirit, may you open our hearts that we may sense your message for each one of us this day. In the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ, we pray. Amen. There must be at least 10,000 reasons why we worship today.
At least.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, O my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before, O my soul, I worship your holy name. It's a new day dawn. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh The end draws near and my time has come. Still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then
had a little fun with this one today. All the songs in our service are in this. Precious Lord, we come today to experience just a closer walk with Thee.
We have at least 10,000 reasons your love for us is more precious than silver.
If we had been there when the woman anointed you with expensive oil,
we would have witnessed a reckless love, unafraid of rejection.
If we knock, knock on the door of heaven, you will ask us to come in.
Blessed be the name of the Lord as we gather together for worship today.
Oh,
before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. And you have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. I couldn't earn, and I don't deserve it, still you yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. When I was your foe, still your love fought for me. And you have been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, you paid it all for me. And you have been so, so kind to me. And oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, don't deserve it, still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God.
To invite all the children to come up for the rhythm section today.
King of kings, Lord of lords, come on and let him in. that, wouldn't you? You could play his drum. Who does? What's your answer?
I think
you
need a metal drum.
Oh, a metal drum. Those sound cool. Probably Pastor Tony has one of those, too. I don't know. Well, today, we continue our special time of the year called... Do anybody remember what we're celebrating? We are celebrating St. Patrick's Day. You are correct. But in the church, remember, we're taking this journey, and we call it Lent. Remember that? We've been talking about it. Okay, well, now you know. A time of growing close with God, and we're halfway to the point of our 40-day journey to Easter. Before we jump into our story for today, let's prepare with our echo prayer. You guys did this with Mrs. Swanson last week. So when I say something, you say something. We will dare to join the journey. We will walk your loving way. We will live your sacred story. Through the things we do and say. Amen. Good job. So in today's story, we experience a meal along with Jesus and his friends. Just like in life, sometimes there's good news and sometimes there's bad news. Every time you're going to hear good news in our story today, you're going to say, Amen. Can we try it? Amen. All right. And when you hear bad news in the story, you're going to go, Aw, man. Let's try that. Aw, man. Okay, so here we go. It was 2 days before Passover and the festival of unleavened bread. Jesus was at Bethany visiting the house of Simon, who had a skin disease. During the dinner, a woman came in with a vase containing a very expensive perfume called nard. She broke the vase and poured the perfume on Jesus' head as a way to honor him. They said to each other, Why waste that perfume? This could have been sold for almost a year's pay and the money given to the poor. They scolded the woman. Jesus defended her, saying, Leave her alone. Why do you make trouble for her? She has done a good thing for me. You will always have the poor with you, and whenever you want, you can do good things for them. But you won't always have me here. She has done what she could. She has anointed my body ahead of time for burial. I tell you the truth, that anywhere in the world the good news is announced. What she has done will be told in the memory of her. Amen. Great job. We celebrate the woman today because she took a chance in showing her love for Jesus. That vase of perfume was worth a lot of money, but the woman knew that Jesus was very special and worthy of the expense, even when the others thought it was foolish. Let's pray. Loving God, help us live your story as we learn it is not foolish to give out of love. Amen.
Time of generosity by thanking Julie. Every year, spring ahead is our liturgical dance time, and each year we've had, in the last recent years, we've had young ladies up here dancing with us, but with COVID, just wasn't feasible. So thank you, Julie, for honoring that and with your talents. Absolutely. The time of generosity today, I want to thank first the Holy Spirit and then our worship design team. This series, as I have been sharing with worship design each week, has been a real challenge to me after that last one that we had that I was so into. So my sermon preparation takes a whole week. And Monday and Tuesday, I try to get things together so that when I come to service design, I'll have somewhat of an idea where we might be going with the message. But this week, Monday, it was like nothing. I'm praying to the Spirit, and nothing's happening. Tuesday happens in the morning when I try to finish this up. I get a few things in there. I can't write a call to worship yet. I can't get the prayer of dedication because I'm just not feeling it. So if you've seen my micro Bible study on Facebook that I put on yesterday, I use these words from Proverbs. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to Him, and He will make your path straight. One thing I've learned with trying to come up with a message each week is wait on Him. Don't try to force it. So Tuesday, I was way behind. Well, we go into worship design, and in worship design, we talk about, you know, what the theme is for the week and what songs we might use. Well, I had realized that Julie had a different song that she was going to dance to, but the Spirit had moved her to go to this song, Reckless Love. And when we were talking about it in Worship Design Tuesday, I realized that's very much relates to what I'm talking about this week or what the Lord wants me to talk about. And then I had another song in my mind called Remember Me. I couldn't figure it out, and Vicki helped me understand that it's actually a communion song. And we went in and looked at it, and we took out some of the communion pieces, and it's still called In Remembrance of Me. But that gave me my message title for today, In Remembrance of Her. And you're going to notice when we sing that song that part of it is going to be saying In Remembrance of Her. So all of this just gave me, the Spirit came into that meeting and through the people in there helped me put this message together today. And I came up from my basement yesterday because Saturday mornings I always kind of try to put the finishing touches on it. And I told my wife, I cannot believe where I've been from Monday to Friday till Saturday on this. Friday's my day off. I call it my day of percolation with the message. If I don't have stuff figured out by Thursday, by going through Friday and waiting that day on Saturday, the Lord usually has something for me. So I hope you enjoy today's message, but I want to thank the Holy Spirit. I want to thank our worship team for their generosity and giving me the message in their time and in His time. So that's it for today. Let us offer our prayer of dedication here this morning. Loving God,
we come with our tithes and offerings, not as an act of extravagance or careless spending, but as an act of devotion. We dedicate these financial resources to the building of your kingdom on the foundation of love, mercy, and grace offered to all in the name of your Son, Jesus. Open our eyes that we may see you calling us to witness loving acts of devotion in our world today. Amen.
Amen. We have a couple of things on the prayer board this morning. First is Dorothy Cowan. Dorothy is recovering in a rehab center there on the corner of Kalamazoo and 44th Street. She'll be in there for a few more days and hopefully coming home soon. She is gaining strength. And then the other one on the board, Dan Reitman talked to me today, and he is approaching this week 8 years since his double lung transplant, which is wonderful. And it's probably a good thing they didn't tell him this earlier, but he talked to his doctor and he said, hey doc, it's going to be 8 years this year. And the doctor said, well, that's great because most people only live for 5 years. So, yeah, God is good all the time. God is good. Let us come before the Lord in silent prayer at this time. Heavenly Father, we thank you for that reckless love that you have for us. Those times when we seem to wander away or lose our direction or even lose our faith. It is you that chases after us. It is you that calls us home through voices of loved ones and through the beauty of a day, the beauty of seeing you paint colors in the sky and upon the land. So, Lord, we thank you for your constant pursuit of each and every one of us. And Lord, we lift Dorothy as she continues to recover, and we lift Dan, 8 years, and many more to come. And Lord, as we begin to slowly but surely come out from under this pandemic, give us your patience. We would love to hurry, to hug, to embrace. But Lord, let it happen in your time, not in our time. And today, Lord, as this message that took so long to develop this week is offered, may we understand that each and every message comes from you, that we have the opportunity to not only speak it, but to hear it. So, Lord, in this day, we give you thanks. As the lady with the alabaster jar who anointed you, may we risk being rejected by proclaiming your name, your love, your mercy, and your grace for all people. We ask this in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
just gets better every week, doesn't it? It's such a beautiful, beautiful song. Well, no matter what the subject is, we can always find an expert to tell us the correct way we should think about any subject. Amen? The reality is, it's always been that way. And until Jesus comes again in glory, it will always be that way. It used to be said, keep your opinions to yourself, unless someone asks for it. That's still a good way to live. It's a very peaceful way to live. But now we have social media. Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, where you can share your every thought and opinion on any subject. Yay! Oh, man! That's exactly where I was going to go with that when I heard that in children's time. Oh, man! I think social media should be cited for disturbing our peace. Amen. But you think about it, we're the one using it too. You can take people off your news feed. You can remove people so you don't have to hear their stuff. I actually have someone on a 30-day suspension right now. No one here. No one here. I had a pastor friend of mine. I was at a conference and he seen something someone posted at conference and he come at me, would you slap this person? And I said, no, I won't. And he come back again and I said, you know, you can take him off your news feed. He's like, oh, that's right. You don't have to let people stir you up all the time. But during Jesus' last week, Jesus is at a meal in Bethany today, which is just outside of Jerusalem. And a woman shows up unexpectedly to this meal. And what she does causes quite a stir. So again this week, I want us to enter into this story. To enter the place where you belong at this table. Not just looking on, for this is also your story. Enter the passion or enter the suffering of Jesus in that last week. Enter the place that we belong. Not just looking on, for this is our passion also. Enter the story. I would like to invite Mary to come up and share our reading for today, Mark 14, verses 3 through 9.
While he was in Bethany, reclining at the table in the home of Simon the leper, a woman came with an alabaster jar of very expensive perfume made of pure nard. She broke the jar and poured the perfume onto his head. Some of those present were saying indignantly to one another, "Why waste this perfume? It could have been sold for more than a year's wages and the money given to the poor." And they rebuked her harshly. "Leave her alone," said Jesus. "Why are you bothering her? She has done a beautiful thing to me. The poor you will always have with you, and you can help them anytime you want. But you will not always have me. She did what she could. She poured perfume on my body beforehand to prepare for my burial. Truly, I tell you, wherever the gospel is preached throughout the world, what she has done will also be told in memory of her."
Thank you, Mary. Number one in our message notes this morning is this is thought to be the last act of kindness that Jesus had done to him during his earthly life. The last person to be kind to him before being crucified upon the cross. So let's move over to our art for this week, our picture. It's a very, very busy picture. And we don't know the author, it's anonymous, but it does come, as all of these pictures do, from Art in the Christian Tradition. It's a project at Vanderbilt Divinity Library. And you can see the people around the table there in the bottom. Let's go just a little bit closer on that view. And you can see the lady down anointing Jesus' feet. I think it says in some scriptures that she had broken this jar, not broken it over his head, but poured it over his head. So let us hear from the person at the table who's observing what's going on today.
None of us around the table liked the way things were going here in Jerusalem. The conversation had turned once again to the dire situation for many of the people we had encountered, those who were hungry, poor, sick, disturbed. But does the Roman state care about them? No. At least we try. Every penny we can scrape up, we try to pass on to those who need it. I had to wonder, though, whether all our talk of asking our patrons for more money right now was really because we were afraid. Before Jesus arrived to dinner that night, some of the disciples had said that with the way things are going, perhaps we should be saving money in case we needed to hide out in the not too distant future. And then she walked in. I saw the jar she carried, beautiful, alabaster. And as soon as I smelled the oil as she began to anoint Jesus, I knew it was nard and it had been expensive, and there was a lot of it. Across the table, the others were beginning to stop their conversations, and looks of contempt began to cross their faces. Mumbling began. Do you know how much that kind of oil costs? It seemed a ridiculous waste, given what we had just been talking about. That kind of money could go a long way. I looked down at her. I was close, and although she had not said a word, I could sense her intensity and devotion. This love lavished on him was somewhat embarrassing, and yet it was what I really wanted to do. Tell him how he had changed my life, and how finally I felt I had purpose in my life. I felt loved, and it was such a gift. But how can you offer any gift to this beloved one? He is the anointed one, anointed by God. But here she is anointing him. I realized that what I felt was jealousy, mixed with a deep fear that we were losing him. I think we were all afraid of losing him. He tells us to stop judging her. She is preparing me for burial. No, I thought, don't say that. It can't happen. Later, I will remember her just as he asked me to do. And I will remember that he asked us to care for all people the way she cared for him that night.
What timing she had. We were talking about the poor. And she comes in and just doesn't take the top off and anoint him like we think of anointing happening on the forehead. She uses it all on his body. And the reaction of those who are always willing to share their opinion were looks of contempt. What a waste of money, they thought. Was it a careless use of an expensive commodity, or was it a beautiful act of love? Then the observer noticed her devotion, and he begins to change his thinking. And he sees it as her devotion and her love for Jesus, and starts to see it as an act of thanksgiving. She's giving thanks to Jesus. Now, it's not documented anywhere, but as often happens when a female shows love towards Jesus, people think that it could be Mary Magdalene, the one that he had saved from being stoned. Could have been her. Doesn't necessarily matter. But she was using a reckless love. She came in and risked rejection and was getting rejection by the act that she was performing. The observer says, I think we all were afraid of losing him. Jesus tells us to stop judging her. She is preparing me for burial. What? He has been trying to tell them over the past few weeks that he was going to die, be killed. They still can't hear it. Our focus text for today, Jesus' words, she did what she could. She poured perfume on my body beforehand to prepare me for my burial. No, the observer says. I thought, do not say that. It can't happen. But later, the observer says, I will remember her just as he asked me to do. And I will remember that Jesus asked us to care for all people the way she cared for him that night. So we're not supposed to just use a soft love. We're to be reckless, like this lady was. Don't spare things when it comes to loving others. Then the last verse, Jesus' words, truly I tell you, wherever the gospel is preached throughout the world, what she has done will also be told in memory of her. And here we are, telling the story in memory of her, in remembrance of her. She is told as an example of reckless love, which is unafraid of rejection. Today's message tells the story in remembrance of me. That is the song we will be singing as our song of affirmation this week. I want to just go through the first verse. We changed it to the word her in here. Hear these words. In remembrance of her, heal the sick. In remembrance of her, feed the poor. In remembrance of her, open the door. And let your sister in. Let her in. In remembrance of her, search for truth. In remembrance of her, always love. In remembrance of her, don't look above, but in your heart, look in your heart for God. Do this in remembrance of her. So, how does this scripture challenge us here today? We've been asked to imagine ourselves in the room as we see the looks of judgment and then outrage on the faces of those around us. And number two in our message notes this morning. As we turn to look at her, are we ourselves moved by her generosity and outpouring of emotion? Or are we stuck by the cost of that perfume? Did the opinion givers, those with contempt on their faces, ever hear what Jesus was teaching? Did they see that she is the only person following Jesus who believed he would give his life for them? Their indignation blinded them from seeing, from hearing, and from witnessing before them what was really going on that day. So what are we going to do about it? What do we walk away with today? I want to invite us to slow down, to take time to look, to take time to listen. Let's even go as far as to keep our opinion to ourselves. number 3 in our message notes. When we are busy giving our opinions, we can miss what's really going on. We're caught up in this world of, okay, here's my opinion. I heard yours. Maybe I didn't hear yours. But when we're busy doing that, we miss what's really going on, what God's doing right there in front of us. She used a reckless love, pouring out this whole jar of expensive perfume on Jesus, preparing his body. It is Jesus that uses a reckless love, giving his life for you and I on the cross. I'd like to thank Julie again for picking this song and for the Holy Spirit for using it in this message. Here are the words from that song, the first verse and chorus. Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found, leaves the 99. I couldn't earn it. I don't deserve it. Still, you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. What if? For those of you who haven't been here before, that means I'm almost done. What if we lived out our faith every now and then? We showed the reckless love of God to others. What if we showed the reckless love of Jesus to others? What if we showed the reckless love of this woman in today's story? What if we practice keeping our opinion to ourselves? We'd have a lot more time in the day. What if we just stop being an opinion giver altogether? And what if we remove looks of contempt from our faces? And what if we look for what God is teaching us in all the situations we find ourselves in? Vicki, I'd like you to come back up, and Julie, I want us to sing that song that we sang just before the message, the song of preparation. I would like us to sing the first part of that song again to close this message today. If I had been there. His place.
my eyes soon would see if I had been there.
Heavenly Father, it's beautiful when we can read a story and see ourselves within that story. Maybe as the ones offering opinions and have indignation on our faces. And then to realize what's really going on in that story is someone loving you. Someone believing you, worshiping and honoring you. And then in our own day, we bring that story forward and put it in our own lives, a time in our society where we seems like opinions are just so prevalent. Lord, may we remember to listen first. May we look and hear and see what is going on before us. Maybe someone's opinion is more of a cry for help than it is a cry for argument or rebuttal. So, Lord, we are a continuation of this story. We are called to share your love, your mercy, your grace, and your forgiveness with everyone who we come in contact with. So Lord, in this day, may we not only picture ourselves in the story, but may we live out the story of seeing and experiencing your presence around us. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Just a little preview.
The
Just a few announcements this morning. The Easter egg goodie bag drive-through. We're not going to be doing it in the park this year. We're going to do a drive-through on that Saturday before Easter at 10 a.m. We are still taking donations out there. Bianca, are there anything else we need in particular for the donations for the drive-by?
Snack cakes.
Snack cakes.
Yeah,
okay.
Those are a little bit harder to find in bulk.
Yeah.
But individually wrapped.
Yep. Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Otherwise, we have tons of
candy. Yeah. Also, on Easter, we are having three different services. There will be two in the morning, sunrise service at 7:30. There will be one here at the church in Memorial Garden and also up on the top of Cemetery Hill. And then at 10 a.m., we're having one service here in the sanctuary. And we don't know how that's going to go. Well, it's Easter, so it's going to go good. But with being at 100 in our seating currently, we hope that that might expand by then. But if it doesn't, we may need to have overflow down in the basement. And if we do, I'm going to expect that the people who attend this church regularly, who are members of this church, that have privileges because you're members, you also have responsibilities. If we end up overflowing, I'm going to expect the members of this church to go down and let the guests be in here for that service. But we'll see how it goes. God only knows, but with God's help, things will happen well. Also, Easter lilies, I believe the forms are on that little table in the back as you go out. If you'd like to offer an Easter lily in memory of someone, the form is back there, and you can turn that in at the office. So, after our preview, let's stand and sing Blessed. Coffee Fellowship last week with social distancing and individually wrapped things. So come down and join us if you are comfortable. That is fine. So go in the peace of the Lord. Do in remembrance of her, look, listen, see what God is doing around you. Go in God's peace. Amen.